Good morning, student. I, Purnima, welcome you to the class, and I'm going to start the chapter today. Two story about flying, and the first part is his first flight. So his first flight, I told you the background yesterday, written by Liam O'Flaherty. Okay, he was a Irish novelist and a short story writer. He was born on 28 August 1896 and he died on 7 September 1984. Actually, he was born in Galway in 1908. He went to one of the most famous college, the Rockwell College, and The Informer in 1925. And his the first novel, The Informer, 1925, and the second novel, Return of the Brute, was also a great success. Then Liam O'Flaherty will be remembered as a major voice in the Irish literary renaissance. Now I also tell you about the theme of the story. Yesterday we have discussed a lot of things. His first flight is a story of hesitation, trial and error. So children, this first flight is a story in which the writer has given the theme that we must not hesitate to do anything. He told this thing, and we must be trying to get success. And definitely, children, if we will do something, the error will be there. So we don't have to sit back disappointed that I've done the error. So how I'm going to do that? Okay, all this thing we have to avoid. And then finally, we will go to a path of success in the end. It is an interesting story of a hesitant and timid seagull. What is a seagull? It's a type of a water bird learning the art of flying, while his two brothers and sister had already learned flying. His fear and hesitation stopped him from doing so. Is diving at the fish due to hunger provide a blessing in disguise? After a shaky start, he spread out his wing and started flying upwards and downwards. It was his first flight. The author gave a message that no one attains success instantly. Repeated trial and errors lead him to success. Now, so children, I will be telling you about the main parts of the story. The young seagull was sitting alone on his ledge. His two brothers and sister had already learned how to fly a day before. The young seagull was hesitant and he failed to fly as he was afraid. He thought that his wing would not support him and he will fall down. His parents, brother and sister regularly taunted him for his cowardice. He saw his mother holding a piece of fish in her beak, maddened by hunger, but the mother did not came to him and gave it to him. So he was maddened by hunger. He dived at the fish. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into space. He was seized with terror. His wings were cutting through the air and he was not falling headlong now. So children, he was mad by hunger. He dived at the fish. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into space. He was seized with terror. His wings were cutting through the air and he was not falling headlong now. Then he completely forgot that he had never flown before. Now he was flying over the wing by flapping his wings. So he flew over the sea now. He was floating on the sea and his family was praising him, offering him a piece of fish. So what is the main points of the story, children? Once again, I revise. Young seagull, he was afraid to fly. The young seagull was alone on his ledge. His two brothers and his sister, they have already learned flying. He did try. He had taken a little run forward. and tried to flap his wings, but that was all he could do. He became afraid. He felt that his wing would not support him, so he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole where he slept last night. His brother and his sister had wings far shorter than his own wings, but he failed to muster up courage. What is the meaning of muster? Gather. And flew. His parents taunted, scolded, and threatened him to leave him starving at the ledge unless he flew away. But nothing could make him fly. Now, children, parents were also, they lost hope and they started teaching flying to the young brother and sister of the seagull. The seagull helplessly watched his parents flying with his brother and sister. They were perfecting them in the art of flying. They were teaching them how to escape the waves and how to dive for fish. The whole family went on taunting him for his cowardice. Maddening by hunger, he dived at the fish. Only his mother was looking at him. She had picked a piece of fish. She was flying across to him with it. He leaned out eagerly. His mother was very near to him with the fish in her beak. Maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. With a loud scream, he fell downwards. He fell outside the ledge and then downwards into the space. A terror seized him. Okay, that means he was very much afraid. He saw his two brothers and a sister flying around him. Now, children, the seagull completely forgot that he was not able to fly. He let himself free to dive, soar and curve at will. He was shrieking shrilly. He saw a green sea beneath him. His parents, his brother and sister were beckoning to him, calling shrilly. He was tired and weak with hunger. His feet sank into the green sea and his belly touched it. He sank no further. His family were praising him and their beaks were offering him scraps of fish. He had made his first flight. So, children, now I am going to do the explanation of the lesson. So, I hope the important points and the background of the story I have already discussed with you. Okay, so now the first flight, I am going to read the lesson. Okay, and that I will be doing the explanation to you. So, children, the young seagull was alone on his ledge. So, children, what is a ledge? Ledge is a narrow horizontal cliff. Okay, a cliff. Cliff is a rock, a narrow horizontal shelf projecting from a wall. Okay, narrow space in the rock. That is a cliff. So, the seagull was alone on his ledge. His two brothers and sister had already flown away the day before. Now, children, flew, flown. The third part of the verb is flown. As you can see, the spelling. Now, children, he was not able to fly as he was afraid. He was very much scared. He was not able to fly. He had been afraid to fly with his brother and sister and with his parents. He was not able to fly now. Somehow, his brothers and sister, they had already flown away with the parents day before. He had been afraid to fly. So, he was so scared that he was not able to fly. Somehow, when he had taken a little run forward to the brink of the ledge, and attempted to flap his wing, he became afraid. Now, what is a brink? Extreme edge or the corner. So, children. He is telling, his brother is telling, the seagull, is the writer is telling about seagull, that he wanted to fly. He went till the ledge, went till the edge means kinara, till the edge of the ledge, and attempted to flap his wing, but he was so scared that he could not fly. The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath. The great expanse. Now the vast sea was stretched in front of them. And it was such a long way down, miles down. It was such a way down, it was mile down. He felt certain that his wing would never support him. Now children, he felt certain that his wings would never support him. He bent his head and ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. So children, he went back to his hole and there he slept at night. He did not have courage to fly. Even when each of his brothers and little sister, whose wings were far shorter than his own, ran to the brink, flapped their wings and flew away. Now children, he had seen his brothers and sister wing were very short, but he started looking that how they ran to the brink, okay, to the edge of the cliff where he was staying, how they flapped their wings and they flew. He failed to muster up courage to take that plunge which appeared to him so desperate. So children, he wanted to fly, but he could not fly because he was desperate. He did not have courage to fly. He was so scared. He wanted to fly like his brother, but he could not fly because he was scared. Now we are here at page number 33. Calling him shrilly. Now children, few word meaning which I would like to discuss. Mustered up means gather. You can note it down. Mustered up means gather. Plunge means to take the risk. Desperate means reckless. Desperate means reckless. Shrilly. In a sharp and unpleasant voice. So what is the meaning of shrilly? In a sharp or unpleasant voice. Desperate is reckless. Upbraiding means scolding. Threatening means intimating. Starve means die due to hunger. So children, his father and mother, that means his parents, came loud. They called him, calling him shrilly. Shrilly means they started, indirectly they started scolding him, upbraiding him. Upbraiding means, I just told you just now, scolding. And then children, threatening to let him stop on his legs unless he flew away. So the mother and father both started scolding him. They told him that they will not give him food now, and then when he will starve, he will automatically fly. That was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near him. So his mother and father, they told him that now we will not bring you food. You will starve on this ledge or you will flew away. But for the life of him, he could not move. Now children, but when he wanted to move, he was so scared that he did not move. So children, that was 24 hours ago. So children, this was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near him. Now 24 hours had passed and nobody had come near him till now. One day before all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with his brother and sister. So children, one day earlier, he had seen that his brother is flying, his brother and sister, they are flying, his parents, they are flying with the brothers and sister, perfecting them in the art of flight. Children, they were perfecting him in the art of flight. They were teaching him giving him clues how to fry in expert manner, teaching them how to skim. Skim means to move lightly just above a surface, water surface. To skim means children in a very light manner, the birds sit on the water surface and from there they, what do? They move lightly. So now they were teaching him the art of skimming, teaching them how to skim the waves and how to dive for fish. And now children, the most important thing, they were teaching him how to dive for fish. He had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring and devour it. Now in fact children, he had seen his first elder brother. Okay, what he had done? He had catch a fish and he had devour, he had eat it. So he had learned how to skim, he had learned how to catch the fish without the help of parents, and now he had devour it also, he had eaten it. Devour means eaten. Standing on a rock while his parents circle around, raise a proud cackle. Now children, his parents, they were moving around him, and children cackle, they were making an unpleasant voice. Now children, when the parents were upset when they saw his condition, they were moving around, raising a proud cackle. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on the big plateau midway down the opposite cliff, taunting him with his cowardice. Okay, taunting means making teasing comments. Cowardice means lack of courage. So children, the parents also starting scolding him that he was not a very courageous person. He was not very courageous man, bird. The sun was now ascending the sky, blazing on his lashed dead face, the south. Now, children, the sun was now ascending the sky. It was evening time now, blazing on his ledge that faced the south. The sun was blazing on the ledge. Okay. And he felt the heat because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. Now, today, children, when the sun was in front of him, inside, in front of the cave, he felt the heat of the sun. Why he felt the heat of the sun? Because he had not eaten anything. He felt the heat because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. He stepped slowly out to the brink of the ledge and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing. So then he stepped slowly out of the brink of the ledge, standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing. He closed one eye, then the other, and pretended to be falling asleep. And now children, he pretended to his parents, though he was so hungry and he was scared to fly. He knew his parents will not give him food, but to just to gain his sympathy, he pretended to close his eyes and he pretended to sleep. Still, they took no notice of him. But children, the parents were determined. They did not want to take any notice of him. He saw his two brothers and his sister flying on the plateau, dozing with their heads sunk into their neck. Children, he saw this time, since they know about flying, so they were sitting on the plateau, dozing their necks. His father was preening the feather on his white back. Preening means making an effort to maintain feather. So what his father was doing, he was preening. What is the meaning of preening? Preening, it is given in the book, making an effort to maintain feather. Only his mother was looking at him. Only children, he came very slowly, he opened his eyes, and what he had seen, that his mother was looking at him. Okay, so she was standing on a little high hump on the plateau. Her white breast thrust forward. Now and again she tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet and then scraped each side of her beak on the rock. Now children, she was provoking him. She was having the scrap of the fish on the, her beak. She was scraping the fish. Okay. Scraping the fish. So that his hunger will rise more. The sight of the food maddened him. Now children, when he saw the fish, he became mad with hunger and he could not stop. How he loved to tear food that way, scraping his beak now and again to wet it. Wet means to sharpen. Ga, 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 he cried, begging her to bring him some food. Now he started crying. He started requesting his mother to bring him some food. Ga, ga, ga. Ga cola, she screamed back derisively means mockingly, but she, instead of giving up the food, she mocked, she laughed at him, okay, making fun of him, but he kept calling plaintively, and after a minute or so he uttered a joyful scream, and then afterward he gave a joyful scream to his mother, but she did not pay any heed to him. His mother had picked up a piece of fish and was flying across to him with it. Now children, his mother picked the food and she came to him. She started flying near him. He leaned out eagerly, tapping the rock with his feet. Now he thought his mother will give him food. Okay. So he was eager. He was tapping the rock with his feet eagerly, trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. He wanted to come nearer, but then she flew with the food in her mouth. She flew. She did not come to him. But she, when she was just opposite to him, she halted, her beak motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. Now, she stopped. Halted means she stopped for a fraction of a second just to show him the fish in her beak. But he could not reach and eat the food. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer, and then maddened by hunger. Now children, till now his mother used to come and used to give him the food, but now children, his mother stopped for a while away from him and she did not provided him any food. He was mad with hunger. He dived at the fish. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downward into space. Now children, he dived. Okay, at towards the want to eat the fish, he went, he started, he jumped, but bad luck children, he fell outwards and downwards into space. Then a monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. Now children, a terror gripped over him. That means a terror overpowered him. He was very much afraid. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a minute. Now children, he could hear nothing. He was sure he would die. He was so much scared. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a minute. The next moment he felt his wing spread outwards. Now children, next moment what he felt? His wing spread outwards. The wind rushed against his breast feather, then under his stomach and against his wing. He could feel the tip of his wing cutting through the air. Now children, he started flapping his wing. And now he could feel, children, that the tip of his wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. Now he was not falling, but he was learning how to fly. He was soaring gradually downwards. So, children, he was soaring gradually downwards. And outwards. He was no longer afraid. Now children, he started learning how to fly. Now he was not afraid. He could fly now. He just felt a bit dizzy. Then he flapped his wing. So he felt a bit dizzy. What is the meaning of dizzy? An uncomfortable feeling of spinning around and losing one's balance. So he felt a bit dizzy. Then he flapped his wing once and he soared upward. He rose upward. What is the meaning of soared? He rose upward. Ga 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 ga. Gla ga pula. His mother swooped past him. So children, his mother, just to make him learn. Okay. Passed by him, her wings making a loud noise. He answered her with another scream. Then his father flew over him, screaming. Now children, he wanted to come near his mother, but then he can hear the sound of the wing of his father. He saw then his two brother and sister flying around him. So now children, they are guiding him, curvetting and banking and soaring and diving. Curvetting is leaping like a horse. Banking and soaring and diving. Banking is flying with one wing higher than the other. And children, then he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly. Now children, with the encouragement and by his brother, his father, okay, he knew that now now he is not afraid how to fly, and commended himself to die and soar and curve shrilly. He was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw vast green sea beneath him. So children, he saw a vast green sea beneath him. With little ridges moving over it, and he turned his beak sideways. Okay. Ridges is mountain ranges. Sideways is towards. Caught means made a cackling sound. And amusedly means happily. So he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly, and commended himself to dive and soar and curve shriekly and shrilly. He was near the sea now. Now children, he had, while flying, he reached near the sea, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw a vast green sea beneath him, with little ridges moving over it. So he saw sea, and then he saw ridges, mountain ranges, and he started moving over it. And he turned his beak sideways and cawed amusedly. Now children, while flying, he was moving his head sideways. Cawed means he made a cackling noise amusedly. His parents and his brother and sister had landed on this clean flooring ahead of him. Now children, his parents and his mother, father, his brother and sister, they want to train him that how to skim. That means how to sit on a sea and now and float in a very light manner and then catch fish. He dropped his leg to stand on the green sea. His leg sank under it. Now children, he want to stand, but since it was a sea, it was water, so his leg sank on it. He screamed with fright and attempted to rise again, flapping his wing. He was so scared when he started sinking that screamed with fright and attempted to rise again, flapping his wing. But he was tired and weak with hunger, so he could not rise. Now children, he was so tired, was so weak with hunger that he could not fly. By the strange exercise, his feet sank into the green sea, and then his belly touched it, and he sank no further. Now children, his feet sank, but his belly touched, his belly means his tummy or stomach touched the water, and now children, he was not sinking down. He sank no further. He was floating on it, and around him his family was screaming, praising him, and their beaks were offering him scraps of dogfish. Now children, the whole family was also became happy, because he not only learned flying, but he had learned how to skim. That means sit lightly on water and float, and now children, he was his praising him, and the beaks were offering him script of doctor. He was now, he can now learn how to catch the fish also. At the same time, his whole family was very happy with him, and they were offering him dogfish. He had made his first flight, so now he had learned about his first flight. So that this children, I end my video here, and this lesson is completed. We will do the question answer afterwards. Dear children, thank you.